Hello children, wishing you a very good day. I'm your teacher Asima Khanam and I welcome you all to this session. In this session today, we are going to talk about the very important and interesting story, The Fun They Had. So before I get started with this story, I would like to ask you a few questions. My question number one, how many of you miss your schools right now? Yes, I know all of you miss your schools terribly, isn't it? What makes you miss your school? Is it the teachers, the learning, your classrooms, your friends? What children, could you please tell me? Yes, of course it is the fun that you used to have in your schools, the fun that you used to have with your friends, the fun that you used to have in your school campus. Does that mean learning does not take place or learning is restricted only to the classrooms or the school campus? Not at all. Learning has never been interrupted, children, these days. We all have been learning. We all have been teaching, of course, through the online classrooms. But what about the fun coefficient? Right? You miss your friends terribly. You miss the fun you used to have in your schools, right? That means the social development was not at all there, isn't it? We used to learn, we had our classes in a very appropriate manner, but what about the social concept? What about the social development? What about the moral development? The social development, or we can say the wholesome development of an individual, is possible only when we intermingle with each other. When we have close associations with our friends, with our teachers, and that is only possible when we are at school, not at home where we are isolated these days, where we are quarantined these days. Remember, social distancing? Yes, children. So this story, you can all relate with your lives right now because we have been isolated in our homes for quite a very long time now, isn't it? So that means in our schools, when we used to go to our schools, we used to have a lot of activities, debates, dance competitions, writing, poetry, and whatnot. And all those activities, they used to help us in becoming refined individuals, good individuals. That means we grow as a matter of social development, physical development, moral development, and whatnot. That is why I said that it is only possible when we intermingle with each other, when we have that connection with our friends, when we have that human touch with our teachers. That means interaction. Nowadays, interaction with our friends, with our teachers is missing. So this story, The Fun They Had by Isaac Asimov, is a science fiction. And it tells us the story of two young children named Tommy and Margie who live in the year 2157. That means this story is a futuristic story about the future where we as human beings have to deal with computers, e-books, telebooks, robotic teachers, mechanical teachers, and not the human teachers. So that means the printed books, of course, would be deleted and there will be no concept of the human teachers, right? So this story, which is set up in 2157, we're going to talk about the children getting education through computers only, getting education at their home only. And one day, what really happens with them, we'll discuss all those things in detail. And before I start discussing the plot with you people, I would like to give you a brief about the author. So the author Isaac Asimov, he was a renowned scholar of the 20th century and the most prolific writers writing in many genres, isn't it? So you might have read about him, his bio, that he was born in Russia and then the family immigrated to United States of America. Okay, and there he became the professor of biochemistry while pursuing writing. And he published his first novel, Pebble in the Sky, in 1950. and an immensely prolific author and a writer, he penned nearly about 500 books. Isn't it great? Amazing. His influential work includes I, Robot, and the Foundation Trilogy. As the, you know, variety of genres, he has written so much, but we can just talk about and highlight some of his important work. Isaac Asimov was also known for writing books on a wide variety of subjects outside the science fiction, taking topics on astronomy, biology, mathematics, religion, and literary biography, children. And a small sample of notable titles include The Human Body in 1963, Asimov's Guide to Bible in 1969, The Mystery Murder at ABA 1976, and his 1979 autobiography, In Memory Yet Green. Okay? And he spent most of his time in solitude, working on manuscripts and having to be persuaded by family to take breaks and vacations. By December 1984, he had written 300 books and ultimately writing nearly 500. So let's talk about death and legacy of Isaac Asimov. Isaac Asimov died in New York City on April 6, 1992. That means at the age of 72, right? So he was diagnosed with heart and kidney failure, diagnosis of AIDS, which he had contracted from a blood transfusion during bypass surgery. He was survived by two children, okay, and his second wife, Janet Jepson. All right, children? So over the course of his career, what we came to know is that Asimov had won several Hugo and Nebula Awards, as well as received accolades from science institutions. So he stated during a televised interview that he hoped his ideas would live on past his death. His wish has come true, with the world continuing to contemplate his literary and scientific legacies. So children, let me begin with the introduction now. This is a very light story which is set in future, and it will make all of you love school. As I said, the story is regarding the school life, right? And how those children who do not go to school miss the school, right? The setting of the story is in the future, where perhaps there will be no schools, no books, and will feel that their ancestors, that is the present generation, which means you all, had fun going to the school. Right? Meeting and helping each other, interacting with your friends and teachers. So dear children, it was a little about the writer Isaac Asimov. Let's now discuss the characters. We have four important characters in our story. The first one, Margie, who is a little girl of 11. Second one, Tommy, a little boy who is 13. And we have County Inspector and the mechanical teacher. All right, as I said, it is a story that is set in future. The background year is 2157. So it is the year 2157. Margie makes a diary entry, which reveals that Tommy has come across a book printed on paper. And the pages on that particular book, they have turned yellow, wrinkled, which proves that it existed centuries ago. The book is peculiar in the sense that it had the same words on it that it had when they read it the very first time. They were not moving like that of a screen. So Tommy found the book in the attic of his house. And now they were discussing the book, the words on it. And they found it very futile. Tommy calls it a waste. Why? Because once the book is read, it's of no use. Children, you all can relate the scene with yourself because you all are used to smartphones, screens, computers, laptops, and whatnot. That means, you know, many of us are not nowadays into the habit of reading books. Maybe we read e-books, maybe we read books online, but what about the books that are there in our library, that are there in our study rooms? So that is why the Tommy, who is like you all, a teenager, a child of just 13, he calls it a waste because once the book is read, it's of no use. And their television screen has had a million books on it, right? Because they were the students of future. They had telebooks, they had e-books, and one cannot throw it away, right? So Margie is of the same opinion, but she is curious to know what the book is about because it was something that she has experienced for the very first time in her life. So Tommy tells her that it's about school. And she hated school. Why she hated school? Because there was a mechanical teacher, a robotic teacher who used to give her work, who used to give her assignments every now and then. And she used to hate it because there was no fun at all. That is what the story highlights. Fun. The fun you used to have in your schools, the fun which you used to have with your classmates, the fun you used to have with your teachers every time you have a class. So that is why Margie, she hated school, right? But now she hated it more than ever because her mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test and she was not able to perform well. She was doing worse and worse. Why? Because the geography section had been geared a little higher as compared to her level. She was just 11 and the setting was more higher. And that is why she had been performing very bad. It was worse. And her mother, she sends for the county inspector, who is actually a round little man. The county inspector tells her mother that it was not Margie's fault, but the geography sector of the mechanical teacher was geared a little too quick and he has slowed that to an average 10-year or an 11-year level. And he assured Margie and her mother that there'll be no problem henceforth. So children, here I would like to discuss a few important points. You know, the traditional form of education. The chapter really highlights the traditional form of education wherein we as children, as teacher, are associated with one another. Children, they are dependent on their teachers, and not only dependent, but they have developed a kind of rapport, mutual relationship with their teachers, wherein they can stop their teachers and try to clear their questions and doubts and queries and whatnot. But when we talk about a mechanical teacher or a robotic teacher, you know, we're going to just talk about the settings for the day. And maybe there are doubts and maybe there are questions. And how are we going to clear our doubts and questions? So that is the flaw. No doubt we have advanced in the technology. We have, science has done wonder after wonder, but never it can replace the human touch. Never it can replace the human interaction. Never it can replace the bond, the connection which we human beings have with each other. So moving on, the Tommy further tells her that the teachers did not live in the house. As I said, they were the students of the future, right? They had a special building and all the kids went there. The building we go to, we're talking about the present schools where we have huge buildings, colored buildings, right? The one you have, Delhi Public School, Srinagar. Can you imagine the building? Yes, children, you can. And that is the basic essence of the schooling, where you have human teachers, where you have tall buildings, where you have colorful buildings. And the kids of the same age learn the same thing. And now, the difference between the Tommy's and the Margie's school, it's completely different. She goes into the school room which is right next to her bedroom, and the mechanical teacher is on and waiting for her. And what she did is that she puts her homework in the slot with a sigh. Why sigh? Because she's not happy about it. She doesn't feel, loud. She doesn't feel good about it. And at the same time, Margie is curious to know about the school that existed in the past. And Tommy tells her that it is not their kind of school. That is the old kind of the school they had centuries ago. And the students had a human teacher who taught them and gave them the homework, right? And also asked them the questions. So Margie argues and is, we can say, astonished, surprised at the same time that a man cannot be smart enough. Because we're talking about computers, we at the same time comparing computers with that of a human being. And she is still thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. And all the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing, shouting, very, very happy in the schoolyard, sitting together in the schoolroom and going home together at the end of the day. And those schools were far better than schools of today because they offered great fun to the students. So children, if we talk about the central idea or the central theme of our story, so the story is actually highlighted the methods of education used in the past and in the present. Now why are we talking about past? Past basically here is the present time. The schools where you all people go, the schools where you interact with your teachers, the school where you have fun with your classmates, where you have fun with your friends. So the comparison between the method of education used in the past and the present, right? And also the importance of the traditional form of education, as I explained earlier, that traditional form of education, of course, is important because you're going to have n number of questions, doubts, and of course, as I said, the growth, the wholesome development of an individual. So if we talk about the message of this story, the fun they had, the author's message is one of the warning we can see against the dangers of computerized homeschooling, which deprives children, yes, I will repeat my word, which deprives children of the benefits of the personal interactions between the students and the teachers, which help them to develop many social skills. And also, you know, more specifically, we can say that the narrative, the fun they had, it deals with the future of education, right? Which will become increasingly computerized, okay? And deprived of the social interactions. Children, I hope you have understood the plot, you have understood the characters. And now let's come to the justification of the title. How many of you think the title is appropriate or the title is a suitable one? Yes, the title quite suits the story, the fun they had. Tommy and Margie find an old book and learn how the schools were different in the past from their time and how much fun the children studying in the schools had. So it also gives us a glimpse of the future education where there will be computers, there'll be e-books, there will be telebooks, and the human teachers will be completely replaced by the robotic or the mechanical teachers. So I would like to recapitulate the important points so that it's more clear. So Margie and Tommy are the students of future schools. Tommy finds a book, an old book about old schools in the attic of his house. And they turn the yellow, crinkly pages of the book and are surprised to see still, words in the book because they are used to e-books and telebooks, right? And they thought the old books to be wastage of resources as it was to be thrown after one use, right? And the telebooks, according to them, they last longer and contain many books together. So Margie hated schools as her teacher gave her test and she performed badly. All right, she hated the slot of putting homework and the test papers. Another character is introduced, which is County Inspector. Margie's mother called the County Inspector, who came with all his equipments and repaired it in an hour. And Margie wasn't happy about it, as she thought it would take the teacher for a few days. But then Margie's bad performance in geography, we came to know children, was due to the faulty setting of the teacher. And then Tommy explained that to her, that centuries ago, the schools were not like her, theirs. They had a man as a teacher who taught students different subjects like English, mathematics, geography. He asked them questions and the students were given homework. They used to interact with the mechanical teacher or the robotic teacher. That means the children of the ancient schools used to have great fun in their schools. So Margie could not actually believe the man to be smart enough to have knowledge about the different subjects. Tommy told her that the school was in a special building and students would go there and children of the same age group studied the same things. And now Margie was interested in reading more about the old funny schools. So we got to know that Tommy and Margie attended schools at a fixed time. And Margie thought about the old schools where kids had a lot of fun studying together and playing. The computer screen of her teacher was flashing new chapters in arithmetics on the addition of proper fractions, but Margie was lost in the thoughts of the old school. So children, this is all about the story, the fun they had, wherein the writer Isaac Asimov has beautifully highlighted two important concepts, the traditional form of the education and the fun that we all have in our schools. I hope I'm clear. Thank you very much. Looking forward to seeing you soon with the new videos. Thank you once again.